Angela from the blog Angela Marie Made, and today I'm going to talk about 5 essential woodworking tools for beginners. I'm also going to talk about a few other tools that aren't exactly essential for getting started, but they're favorite tools of mine, so I want to share about them. I think it's important to just learn how to use the most essential woodworking tools when you're first getting started. Tools can be a little overwhelming to learn at first, so if you just focus on learning how to use the essential ones, you'll feel a lot more comfortable going forward when you want to add more tools to your collection. Also, tools are an investment and can be expensive to purchase a lot of them at once. So if you just start out with buying the essential ones, it won't be as expensive and it's better for your budget. The following 5 tools I'm going to share about are the tools that I use the most in my DIY furniture builds and home improvement projects. One very important thing I want to mention is that no matter what tool you end up using, you should always refer to your tool manual and instruction guide on how to properly use that tool. The first essential tool is a power drill. A power drill is like your BFF in woodworking. I use it for almost every single home improvement project and DIY project that I do. It's great for drilling holes into wood with different size drill bits, and it can also be used to drill holes into other materials like brick, metal, vinyl, plastic, lots of different options. A power drill also uses a screwdriver bit to quickly screw and unscrew screws. There are all sorts of different drill bits that you can do other things with as well, such as drilling pocket holes or tightening hex nuts. Other drill bits can drill large holes. There's bits that can mix things like mortar with a mixing attachment. There's all sorts of different things that you can do with the drill. We own a DeWalt drill and we've had it for many years. My husband and I both love it. It works great for many types of projects, and I would highly recommend it. Essential tool number 2 is the miter saw. Miter saws can make very precise wood cuts, both straight cuts and angle cuts. I think the miter saw was one of the scariest tools for me to learn when I first started woodworking, but once I learned how to properly use it, it wasn't scary anymore. There are many different sizes and types of miter saws available to purchase. From compound miter saws to sliding miter saws, they can all handle cutting different thicknesses of wood, different sizes of wood, different angles. So you really want to do your research and read through the details when you're purchasing your first miter saw. I currently own a 12-inch compound miter saw by Hitachi. I don't know if I'm saying that right. And I also own a smaller 7-inch miter saw by Ryobi. They've both been really great saws. I've had the 12-inch one for over 6 years, and it has had minimal problems over that time. I've had the Ryobi one for probably about 5 years, and it's been great as well. I do plan on upgrading to a sliding miter saw in the near future, but they are usually more expensive, so that's something to consider when you're determining which miter saw to pick for the first time. Also, when using your miter saw, you should always wear safety glasses or goggles. And I love my pink safety glasses. They're really cute, and I will link them below as well. Miter saws come with a standard blade that's usually a lower tooth, which means that it makes more of a rough cut and less of a finer cut when you're cutting wood. So you usually want to upgrade the blade and buy a higher quality one with a finer tooth so that you have less tearing of the wood when you're using it. Essential woodworking tool number 3 is the Craig Jig. The Craig Jig is by far my favorite woodworking tool and really helped to make woodworking more simple and possible for me. It joins 2 pieces of wood together through pocket holes and Craig screws. I have a video tutorial on how to use one linked below. I use the Craig Jig in many of my DIY furniture projects, which you will often see. Essential tool number 4 is a power sander, more specifically an orbital sander. A orbital sander is used to sand wood quickly with sandpaper that attaches to it. Sanding is essential in creating a beautiful wood finish in woodworking. When you have an orbital sander that makes the process go a lot faster, it really makes the process easy. It's way faster than hand sanding. I will link my tutorial on how to sand wood below in the description box. I currently have a DeWalt orbital sander and it's been great. I have had a different brand in the past, which I'm forgetting which brand it was, but it wasn't great. Like, the sanding attachment would fall off all the time. The DeWalt one has not done that at all, and it's been a great tool. Lastly, essential tool number 5 is a brad nailer. I use my brad nailer for many home improvement projects, and I also use it in a good number of furniture building projects. It's used to quickly drive brad nails into wood to attach pieces of wood together. The brad nailer that I use is the Ryobi 18 gauge cordless brad nailer. It's been a really great tool. It's not perfect. It sometimes gets the brad nails caught in it and they don't release. So I have to add some WD-40 to the tip part. But besides that, it hasn't had any other issues. It's a really budget-friendly tool, so it's great for getting started, and I would recommend it as well. All right, that's it for the 5 essential woodworking tools for beginners. I want to take some time to quickly chat about some other tools that are favorites of mine, though I don't think they're essential for getting started. The first is a circular saw. I do use this tool pretty often, though not as often as the other ones I mentioned, and I don't think it's essential because you can have the majority of your large cuts made at a home improvement store. They do them for free, so I actually have them do those cuts for me a lot of times, even though I do own a circular saw. You can also use a table saw, but that takes up more room and is more expensive. So a circular saw with a straight edge guide works great as well. And it's definitely a tool I would recommend getting as your next step up in woodworking once you're ready for it. The next tool is not a power tool, but it's a clamp or multiple clamps. Clamps make my woodworking life way easier. They're used to secure a piece of wood to your surface so that it doesn't move when you're attaching it to another piece of wood. And I really recommend getting some clamps if you're able to. And over time, you can build your collection and get different sizes of them as well. Lastly is the Dremel tool. I love my Dremel. It comes with multiple attachments that you can use to do all sorts of things. And I'm not going to get into all the details here, but it's a really fun tool to have, and I use it instead of a jigsaw in the majority of my projects. It's definitely not essential. You don't need it to get started, but it's a really nifty tool that's handy to have. Well, that's it for this tool overview. I hope it's been helpful. Again, I'll link to all of the tools that I talked about and that I use in the description box below. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks again for stopping by, and please subscribe to my channel.